let's have a look at what a scenario looks like both as the director as well as the user. To load a scenario, the director simply double-clicks the button of the scenario that he or she wants to load. Now, the director is going to see all the files loading, but what this is doing in the background is populating the documents library, news aggregator, loading all of the events, and enabling the user's access. Before everyone begins a scenario, you'll likely have a short briefing session. However, it's also a good idea to have a starter email from the director. So what you see on the right is that the scenario is ready to go. On the left, that we're getting into our email. All of the email events are already preloaded and can include any file attachments. When we're ready to begin the simulation, we make sure that we're on the terminal box and press any key. Then we come back to our webmail window to see the first email come in. All of the emails automatically go to the director so they can see the simulation live as well. When you're creating a simulation, you have a choice to time events or to set them up to advance manually. When running the simulation manually, we recommend having a schedule of events and times to ensure that emails, news updates, or intranet updates are delivered when needed to keep the simulation running smoothly. Now, we've switched to the user view. As the event kicks off, users read emails and download attachments. We recommend having an activity brief delivered in the kickoff email. But most importantly, what you can do in the SimulaCranium system is have any kind of attachment that makes sense for your organization and training context. For example, you could have action documents that have to be filled in, attached, and returned. You could have informational updates. Essentially, anything you would normally do and share in your industry's working environment works because the simulation is running on the user's regular computers, tablets, and phones. In this case, the users are saving their work and getting ready to send it back to the director. Naturally, the tool allows for live exchanges between any of the participants at any point in the scenario. So we're having a look at one email exchange. In this case, the team is feeding back the initial deliverable to the director, but also asking a follow-up question. We have our email text, we get our attachment, and we get ready to send it off. And then we come back to our director. And here's our email for the director to take a look at. So they naturally see the question and respond. Live exchanges like these allow for a more realistic simulation experience, allowing for full interaction between participants, groups, and the trainer. Directors can also then build in different kinds of feedback to be delivered to the groups, either as an event or delivered live. Feedback can add to the user's experience, help steer the participants, or even throw them a curveball that they have to deal with, depending on the objectives of the simulation experience. SimulaCranium's platforms are designed to be as flexible as possible for organizations, applicable in most industries, and are also designed to get all participants involved. They're designed to be used on a closed wireless system, meaning that no one gets to visit the real internet during the simulation, but it's to provide also a scaled-down version of information that you want them to see and use. This supports research on effective simulation design because the environment is meant to be a limited facsimile of a real situation. Additionally, effective simulation design creates tasks that require teamwork and multi-person engagement. Therefore, as simulations progress and members need to use different resources, whether they're news or current events, or from an intranet in an organization itself, having every person be able to access the simulation on their own devices not only simulates a real working environment, but drives participants to engage more deeply with the task, the material, and each other. Therefore, SimulaCranium's design is meant to engage both the participants and their favorite devices. This stands in direct contrast to some of the other simulation systems on the market because they typically rely on a single computer and screen, allowing people to phase out, be excluded, or lack the control of information flow during the event. It also just doesn't mirror how people consume and use information in team settings in a modern professional context. The implication of this, an important implication of simulation design, is having enough material to actually occupy a team for the duration of the simulation. But this doesn't mean that simulation developers need to reinvent the wheel with each simulation. Most organizations have a wealth of information available, use existing news, and creatively adapt existing material to suit the simulation. A word of advice, it's important to ensure a diverse set of materials from different media. Now, as you've been watching, the SimulaCranium platform was designed to be used effectively on any internet-connected device. It's a robust system that scales well to laptops, tablets, and phones. It's been designed to be flexible and adaptable for any office or field setting. Finally, by keeping the simulation tool consistent in SimulaCranium, flexible no matter the organization, context, or content, participants will have a familiar and comfortable platform for engaging with different kinds of materials.